existing along White House Lane, Main Stage Road, Bensky Road, during rush hour to and from Liverpool. If you don't believe me, ask members of the Barnston Women's Institute how dangerous it is to cross Barnston Road. I have seen it. I cannot imagine what building of 1,200 houses, 7,000 land, would do to this traffic problem. However, as soon as I pass the tunnel and Birkenhead from Liverpool into the Wirral, I feel my stress leveling and going down. By the time I arrive home, I actually totally chilled. I couldn't explain why I became chilled until my wife told me it is the green fields and open spaces and the beautiful scenery of the world. It was not because I left my work. I loved my patients and I loved my job. It was the trees, open green spaces and farmlands I passed every day to reach home, be it Houghton or Heather. Such an environment is essential for mental health and good quality life, if not life itself. This can partly explain why there is a difference in the life expectancy between East and West Wirral. With widespread mental health problems, especially there, I can understand why we now have eco and agricultural therapy on prescription for patients suffering from stress, anxiety, depression, and even the disabled. I held positions in the Royal Society of Medicine, the Royal College of Anaesthetists, and for a period in the Intensive Care Society of UK. I had to go and stay in London about 10 times a year. It was a concrete jungle. I breathed polluted air, heard sirens, sounds of cars, the hum of the underground, and the crowd. In a state of birds, wildlife, or the silence of peace and quiet. There was nothing green as the Wirral. Every time I went to London, I couldn't wait to come back to the Wirral. The Leverhulme state proposal and appeal, if accepted, in my opinion, will irreparably damage the green belt and all the health benefits that goes with it. Merging of villages, making bigger concrete conurbation, will cause flooding and great loss of productive farmlands just when we need it most. It will be tantamount to stripping off the most valuable and important asset of all residents of the world. After retirement, my artist's friends took me painting around the east and west of the world. I could see for myself how much regeneration and development is needed in Birkenhead, Seacombe, Wallasey, Dockland, and the waterfront. This was done in Liverpool waterfront for many years now. Yet, the Liverpool do not appear to have listened to where the people or what they want or need, or carefully listened or carefully studied existing problems such as traffic. The council has shown housing needs can be covered under using brownfield sites, mainly in the east side of the Wirral, where the need is greatest and the infrastructure is already in place. The name Leverhulme is associated with social welfare, philanthropy, and beautiful estates for working people. The Leverhulme estate presently should be supporting a local council plan and communities. Leverhulme proposal, in my opinion, will not be a poor sunlight or a sword in half. Flooding the Wirral with so many houses unneeded will be an invitation for second home buyers. We will end up like some parts of the UK which have empty second homes, and the Wirral natives neither able to rent nor buy a home in which they can live